Hello everyone, and welcome back to Atelier Rise at All. I'm not gonna say the subtitle every single time, but mostly because I don't remember what it was.
Something something fairies.
Yeah, Secret Fairy, Lost Legend, something like that. Anyway, we were going off to gather materials. Because of course in the first hour-long episode, we didn't even manage to get to alchemy. Oh, right, start to check quests and stuff. And there's, you know, a bit of lore and descriptions about everything you've been doing. Oh yeah, container. And you can access your container anytime you're in the city. Like anywhere while in the city. There's women, because of course. You get weapon, armor, and two accessories for every character.
And by the look of it, the party interface actually will depend on who you have and showing how they interact.
Oh, you mean the...
the way they're standing there?
Yeah. It just gets more people as you get more.
That's kind of cute.
Yep. Gathering tools. We currently have none other than our staff. And adventure... oh, they're separate now. Nice. Formations. Well, they're kinda locked right now for obvious reasons. Anyway, going back out of the city, I suppose. Yeah.
Here we go.
And they're gonna. I can check the entire... well, a good amount of chat way back. Oh, and it even lets me play the voice for it. Interesting. That's cool. And new. Well, either way. Off we go!
Yes, 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 yes!
この辺りは人の往来があるから、出るとしてもそんなに危険な魔物じゃないよ。
Yeah, we've encountered some before. All right.
とは言っても、魔物には違いないんだけど。くれぐれも慎重に行動しよう。
私実際に街道を通ってきたし、なんとかなるでしょう。さあ、気合い入れて採取するぞ。
もう待ってよ、ライザ
ー。 Something's never changed.
Of course.
We kind of already know about that, but yeah, it seems to gather them. It things with different tools to gather different things. Interesting. So that's what the stars are. Okay. Yep. Hold X for a big swing. Of course. Yep.
今日はどんなことが起こるかな。冒険は毎日がドキドキだよ。
Northern Windflower. I wonder, do we still have the... ah, there it is. Yep. You can just look up where things are. Including everywhere where you can gather things. So if you found something, you can just look up where you found it.
Hey!
Koshiko! Mine, Kondo!
Hey!
Take it out! Kyoto!
Hey!
So,
yeah, he's definitely gotten quite a lot stronger. He did start a bit behind us because probably because the game didn't really expect us to fight along the way. Oh well.
Okay,
some more. That was nice. What's my actual quest? Unique and some more and fluffy wool. Makes sense. Oh, we don't have the tool required for this.
So you might need a pickaxe for that.
Probably. Something like that. Honey! Well, beehive, but close enough. Yes, exactly. Oh, this one's neat. It's a potato.
Potato.
There's one.
It's rare drop, doesn't get the one thing you want from it.
Well, of course, that's how it usually goes. We're looking for the common drop, so he will
especially
never...
when I'm here.
Exactly. But you know, we're looking for the common drop, so of course he will drop the rare one.
Grumbles and Giddens. Grumbles and two covert lethalities.
Yep. And Whistle, that's another returning monster.
That is an interesting take on a weasel.
Yeah, it's cute.
And you're beating the shit out of it.
Yep. I mean, when did that stop us before? Don't have an axe.
Okay,
now what was that chest? We busted.
Gonna be completely real, I wouldn't even call those battles.
Yeah, I mean, it is just the beginning.
It's just two college kids beating the shit out of local wildlife.
Exactly, it's just the beginning. It is nice to be able to swim. Holystone Fragment. That was like... I think that was pretty like the... Yeah, no kidding. That... We kinda thought that was kind of unique to Korken, but I guess not.
すごくいい形にした。けどライザは形はどうでもいいとか言いそうだな。
Alright, so this way, I guess. Oh, the chest is up there, isn't it?
やっぱり糸は苦手だよ。目が痛くなってきちゃう。
Sisters are wrong. I see. It's something to do with those trees, I guess.
糸を集めるのも慣れたものよ。敵だ。気をつけて。
But yet the battle still do get harder later.
連続よ。 So for right now, all it is just, like I said, two college kids bullying the local wildlife.
And yeah, basically. Hey, level up. Oh, I guess this is the road. Okay, so either way, that's a later thing, so we can get the chest yet. Let's go find more fluffy sheep. And beat the shit out of it.
So go find another sheep to shake down for its lunch money.
That's worth for it. There's one. Never mind. Look, they are very white.
What was it?
I confused a rock with a sheep. Oh.
Geronimo!
Hey,石 だって! やり方次第で立派な素材になるよね。
Yes, we can. Don't mind that.
Leash dump the camera into her rear.
I'll try not to. All the time.
Every now and then you want to take a view though, huh?
Can you blame me? Oh, there's a lot of sheep. Okay, we actually got the thing this time.
Got the thing!
We might have taken a while.
もうそろそろ必要な数は揃ったかな?
Right, so did you lose track of time again?
She's
been waiting all this time.
Of course. She's curious.
それじゃ早速錬金術の調合をします。と言っても、こっちで取れた素材と新しい錬金釜だから、慣れるまで大したものは作れないけど。
Fair enough.
失敗の言い訳を今から考えているのか?
<笑>違うって。新しい武器や道具を使うときって慣れるまで少しかかるでしょ。そんな感じ。まあまあ、できるやつでいいから早くやってみせてよ。 まったく。ちょっと待ってね。
Finally, when I get the alchemy tutorial, huh? Alchemy skill tree. The skill tree will give you access to the recipes Raisa learned on Gurken Island and some useful synthesis skills. Oh, that's different. You will need SP to unlock the skills. SP is gained by synthesizing items and exploring ruins. And hold A to unlock the explosive uni recipe. so you can demonstrate the power of alchemy to your party members. You have learned the explosive uni recipe. When you learn certain skills, your skill tree might grow. Learn a variety of skills and grow your tree.
Yes. じゃあ始めるよ.
Do I need more fertilizer? It doesn't mean SP is fertilizer.
何にしようかな?
Anyway, before you can synthesize an item, you need to learn its recipe. Your speak recipe you already know. You can synthesize an explosive unit, so press A to select it. Yep.
どこに入れようかな?
In the center of the screen are the material loops, where you can add materials. You need to add the materials specified by the material loop in order to synthesize the item. At the moment, some material loops are locked, preventing you from adding materials. First, cast one of your units you gathered into the middle material loop. Makes sense? Scattering unit or exploding unit. So depending how much or how good a unit put, it can improve the effect. Making sense there, Derek? Hello? Test, test?
Check.
There you are.
My mic, I had to mute my mic for a minute because there were some unusual background sounds.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sort of following.
So I can technically put more uni in there to get the exploding uni instead of scattering uni. Adding the uni added a new effect to the item that you are going to synthesize. All material loops have one of the four elemental attributes, fire, ice, lightning, or wind. Red color stands for fire, blue stands for ice, yellow stands for lightning, and green stands for wind. Adding materials with the same elemental attribute as the material loop will let you increase its power, also known as its elemental value. Accumulating an elemental value above a certain level will bring various benefits, such as raising the item's quality and unlocking new effects. Now, let's add materials to the other unlocked material. This is effect
2.
So, it just needs materials related to gunpowder. As you can see, it's good. Give me a few more options. Also, I need to lower the sensitivity of the left stick because it does that. So, can I
just use the pad?
Yes, that. I really should be using that. Okay, I can add multiple items at once. After adding materials to the material loop, you can press enter to begin the synthesis process. I mean, press start. Alternatively, you can also add more materials to the newly unlocked material loop on the upper right. Some material loops will require certain elemental attributes and values to unlock the connection. As you become more familiar with the synthesis process, pay attention to the conditions under which the material loops are connected. You still have some materials remaining, so try adding some to the other material loops. So that would increase quality and is a kind of fuel. So, you know, dry grass. I guess it can be used as fuel. I guess it's still tutorial time. Adding more materials has further strengthened the final item. As you can see, unlocking more loops and adding new materials will allow you to create more powerful items. However, each recipe has a set limit to how many materials you can add. The maximum number of materials that can be used in this specific recipe can be seen on the bottom of the screen. Yeah, it's definitely still tutorial time.
You don't say.
In the first game, at least you could increase the amount of materials you could use as you increase your alchemy level, so maybe that will still be a thing. If the materials you chose have traits, you'll be able to transfer those traits to the synthesized item. You can transfer up to 3 traits, but first you'll need to unlock the required 3 slots. 3 slots are unlocked by leveling up the material loose, featuring this specific bonus. Try leveling it up when you find one. Furthermore, some traits can be strengthened by synthesizing materials carrying the same trait. Now then, select which trait you'd like to transfer or just press and start to synthesize the item. No le quemar chicos, we don't have any trait loose. Explosive unit. So it's a shrapnel bomb, basically.
The little bow on it.
Yep.
ひやつ驚くよね。全然違うものができるから。どう？これが錬金術だよ。正直驚きました。こんなすごいものが本当にあったなんて。 錬金術を使えば何でも作れるよ。いや、さすがに何でもはちょっと言い過ぎか。何でも本当に。
I think we just got ourselves an apprentice.
どうしたの？ あ、いえ、何でもないです。
Jeetri-senpai.
ライザの錬金術が健在で安心したよ。
Is it possible to learn this power?
Yeah.
I like it when game sequels aren't like direct immediately after, like we can actually see them have like work and how what's happened with the lives in them and stuff. Find it interesting.
And then I really hope to get around to porting Zillia and Zillia 2.
あたしを何だと思ってんの。いろいろ準備もいるだろうし、ライザの用意ができたら声をかけてよ。待ってください。今度は私もついていきます。
パティ、それは
危ないと思うし、やめた方が。でも、そう、実は私も遺跡には以前から興味を持っていたんです。
She's like the Shirabe of this game.
そんな話初耳だ。
She really just wants to learn alchemy.、
Listen to hypnotize anybody. Listen, that's gonna be my joke throughout this entire game series.
I'm pretty sure that'd be anyone's joke for the entire series.
今日はここでお開きかな。それじゃ、また明日ね。ちゃんと疲れを取っておくんだな。Sure,
I totally won't be engrossed in doing more alchemy. That will never happen.
No, never.
Like, there were always side quests. Like, there were actual side quests in the first game. That required me to wait until the next day or a couple days for things to happen. Do you think I went to sleep to pass the time?
That's what they would hope you did.
I just went to the cauldron.
The cauldron is Rice's bed.
Yeah,
that.
Neutralizers. Alright, that's time. Okay. Oh yeah, there it is. Quantity of materials. There's a lot of things here. But I think I'll wait for that because that's kind of an important thing to get. So that's gonna be relevant.
Maybe.
We can see. Runa lamp. That sounds like it's gonna be important. Oh, we can just do that. Good enough for now.
She is indeed the Genki of the Genki girls, isn't she?
Pretty much. Does that make her the Kirika?
I guess.
Well, I guess she would be more like Hibiki.
Yeah, you can't keep Hibiki down.
Also, yeah, you can just press select to just return.
That's nice.
Alright, let's try making something a bit more different. Oh, those are still locked.
Oh.
Well, let's add one more. Okay, so I guess those are still locked for some reason. And I'm curious about why within. Do we have the three
fingers?
Oh, well. There we go. Quality traits of
things.
いろいろやってみたいな。
いい感じ。さすが私。
Yay! We got thingies and stuff. Can we still equip those though? I mean, probably can. Oh, right, items. No. Equipment? Doesn't seem to be a thing yet.
I'm sure it'll bring it up at some point.
Oh, no! Now it's nighttime.
Because you spent a good couple hours doing alchemy.
Yep.
Or most of the day, I should say.
Welcome to Ryza, losing track of time.
Yeah!
Oh, it's not that way. This way, right? Yeah. Don't mind the fact that we're a bit late.
I'm gonna laugh if they actually call you out for it.
Me too, because that didn't happen in the first game, and now I'm really curious if they have that kind of... At least I don't think they did in the first game. So...
Yeah, Ryza.
We were waiting all day.
もう準備できてるんだね。
うん、体力もバッチリだよ。
それじゃ、早速行くとしよう。
Nope.
まずは街道に出るよ。
Painpei Cauldron.
よし、未知なる遺跡に向かって。 いざ、出発。
Not much else to start at. Yay! Just an idea. Ah, it's based on their dexterity. Okay. Item brush. In order to use items in battle, you need to have enough core charge. Charge can be earned by using skills. Plus, if you have enough core charge, you can activate an item brush that allows you to use multiple items at once. Oh. Build up your core charge and use item brush to gain an instant advantage. Yeah, that sounds like it would be useful. You can also use an item out of turn by using 10 AP and activating quick item. Kinda useful, huh?
Well.
Don't forget to use it when you're close to defeating an enemy, or if your party's in a pinch. CC bottle. Core charge that you don't use in battle will be saved in your CC bottle. Core charge stored in the CC bottle will allow you to use equipped healing items while in the field. You can equip healing items by accessing your basket and... yeah. In combat, when you fulfill various conditions, such as stunning an enemy, your allies will issue action orders. If you fulfill the conditions of the action orders within a certain amount of time, your allies will use the order skills. All of the order skills are powerful, but you will need to meet the requirements that include other actions than normal attacks to activate them. Use your skills and items productively to fulfill your action orders. Yep, sounds about right. So now I can equip them. Yep, there it is. You get one, and you get one. I should have made another one. Oh well. Hey, bud. There we go. And the weather. Eastern Central District. We probably have been way easier to just teleport back to the atelier. In fact, let's learn this one. Hidden items are useful.
何にしようかな。
そう、we can do this. No, not that. Outdoor materials, high quality.
すごいのできちゃうかも。どれにしようかな。うんうん、悪くないね。
There's more animations for this as well now. That's cool.
どこに入れようかな。
Yeah, being able to use Outdoor the alchemy can be pretty nice. Especially since it's not exactly anything crucial. It's just I'd like to have a healing item on everyone. So I'm making Drifto. That's a nice little dance.
The next day.
Yeah. She used to not be nearly as emotive while. While doing alchemy. Yeah, what does she use? Is that a naginata?
I believe no. That is a form of naginata.
Or it might be an odachi.
I would assume a odachi has a shorter handle though.
I mean, look at her image with the actual.
Yeah, sword. It's swung across her back like a sword would be.
Yeah. I guess we'll have to see. It's the next sundown.
Mm-hmm. I guess that'd be a form of nodachi, but it's kind of excessive.
Maybe. Mm. I wonder if this game will let you change who you're moving around as this time. You could only in the first game because, you know, lots of tools and stuff.
さて、これから遺跡に向かうわけだけど。実は、オートの周辺には遺跡と呼べそうなものが、僕が知る限りだけでも5つあるようだ。
え、5つも？そんなに？
それで5つのうちで唯一見つかってる遺跡が今回の目的地さ。
For today, even though we're leaving at sundown.
すでに見つかってるところに行くの？それってもう調べ尽くされてるんじゃ。
ところがね、
オートの
人間は遺跡なんて興味がないみたいで調べようとすらしてないんだよ。町のすぐ近くに大きな遺跡があるっていうのに気づいてない人の方が多いくらいでね。
町の近くにあるんですか？私もそんなの聞いたこともないですけど。
Yet I would explain it.
パティ、遺跡に興味があるって言ってなかったっけ？
That was quick.
興味があることと知っていることは別です。興味があるから勉強するんじゃないですか？
All you're interested in is dice. And you know it,
buddy. 5つの遺跡を探し出して調査することになるんだね。
うん。でも、これはあくまで文献とかで知ったってだけで、本当に5つあるかは分かってない。
Fair enough.
それぞれ別の文献に載ってて、別の遺跡だと思っていたら、実は同じものを指していた、なんて可能性もある。
なんか結構ふわっとした話なのね。
Well, yeah. That's kinda how it works. 実際なんてのは
大抵ふわっとしたもんだよ。ライザだってそれは知ってるだろ。
Yeah, no shit.
ただ、僕はある程度の確信みたいなものを持ってる。ほら、伝承の文章を話しただろ。あそこに5って数字が出てくる。あれは遺跡が5つあるってことを指してるんじゃないかって思うんだ。
それはそうと、目的の遺跡なんだけど、この街道から北にそれた森の奥にあるって話だよ。森の奥。魔物は出るのでしょう。There must have seen the actual main road. Of course there must have seen this forest. それは分からないな。でも森だし、魔物じゃなくても猛獣なんかは出てもおかしくないだろうね。 I guess they do have make an actual distinction between
モンスターさん、just animals.
Yep. Other characters also make different comments on things you pick up. So I guess you did kind of see a bit of the...
Yep.
Before. Anyway, of course, we'll be picking up everything we find along the way. She's also very formal.
I mean, she is supposed to be the scion of what passes for a noble house in the city, isn't she?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it makes sense.
She was confident about that one, at least. Good question, then. Can we drop down there? Probably. Doesn't really lead anywhere, though, so I guess it doesn't matter.
But Ran! Explore everywhere!
I can say for sure we'll be coming back at some point.
Oh, I'm sure.
And Patty going with, I should collect as many...
I mean, it's plainly obvious what she's, why she's coming with us.
That is, of course. I mean, not coming. Are you alright?
Who, me?
Yeah, you kinda cut off.
Huh.
Oh wow! A green slime!
Eh?
Sunlight.
She wields it more like a... She would wield a pole arm. Yeah, of course that helps. She's small. She is small.
The order action, so well, one of them managed to trigger a special attack and then the unit just died. Pony, whatever.
Ooh, squishy squishy.
Yeah, that. Yeah, what level is she? Okay, she started at level 6, like. Which is probably just the lowest level on the team or something. I don't know.
Don't ask me for answers!
I don't know
what I'm doing half the time. And now we're back to college students beating up the locals.
Hmm. But yeah, you fulfill both of the error directions in one go. They both get a special attack. I still can't tell whether it's supposed to be a pole armor or a sword.
Like, she's wielding it in both ways.
Yeah. Which I guess makes it a very flexible weapon.
Yeah, I guess.
Can we... Blessed feather. So where are we going exactly? Oh, this way anyway. It's probably what a lot of players are having seeing this game.
Man, what the fairy do to you?
It had materials. That was some timing.
Out the horizon, early game. Local college students exterminate local wildlife for crafting materials.
Yeah, pretty much. And more questions.
Those are monsters. They're sheep.
I was about to say.
Oh no, it's an aggressive sheep.
Battles take place within a single restricted area. If there are multiple enemies within the same area, they will gain the area boost. Enemies within range of the area boost will become stronger, so try to pick off the more vulnerable ones first. Stunning enemies within the battle area can promote the area boost effect. The stunning enemies simply continue attacking them until you fully deplete their stun gauge. So, definitely tutorial. Stunned enemies will be immobilized for a short time, and all attacks on them will become critical hits. So yeah, you could say stunning them is rather useful. Continuing to attack a stunned enemy can eventually cause them to break down. So just bully it until it starts
crying. Yeah, pretty much.
If you break an enemy down, they won't be able to move for a while, so it's a good idea to aim for it whenever you can. That's it for this tutorial. Take some time to experiment and learn how to fight. Yep. Yeah, that's breakdown, right?
The talk about you don't seem to be doing but one damage.
You were saying? It was probably used for the tutorial.
I guess.
The skills at least did quite a lot more damage, so...
Kaido acting tired for?
Did we even take damage?
Don't think so.
When it helps that I'm still pretty familiar with the combat system. And it hasn't changed too much yet. Did you see Patty just red face? Them dice though. See? She saw the dice and immediately looked back up.
The power of dice compels you!
That reminds me, I should be able to... information maybe? There we go. That does not change who I'm... moving around here, and I probably won't, but... it will at least change who I'm... who it defaults to in the combat. Skill tree, equipment, items... okay. More flowers! Anything to loot around here?
Hey!
To be for... yep.
Hey! Yoisho!
Giant rocks, we definitely cannot take those. Is this the right way though? And I guess we technically could go along the river and get some stuff. Not sure how we'd get back up though. Well, too late. The fuck is that?
Barrier. That is a pixie.
Yep.
Which y'all are probably going to proceed to bully the hell out of.
Maybe.
Yeah, I figured as much. Bloody bully, it's a lot of you.
Oh, we're actually taking a decent amount of damage.
Well, don't! I hear it's bad for you.
Oh, wait, what? Not what I meant to do. I guess everyone needed a bit of time. Okay, so what's this saying? Ah, there we go.
これで終わりよ。そば。よっ。なあ。チョキ。僕に合わせて。そう。受けてみなさい。僕が行く。
There we go. That was a bit more difficult than I expected.
Ah, you're fine!
Yeah, we just actually took damage.
Yeah.
But the real question is, how the hell do we get back? Oh, I think I saw it. Yeah, we can just go from here. So the devs did think about it. Is there anything down south? Not really. There's a big enemy over on back there.
Do you feel lucky?
No.
Yep.
Hey! これ小さな石とかも混ざってるけどいいのかしら?
Oh, just swing at bricks. What? Into the ruins we go? Oh, wait. We need a second very long episode. Welcome to JRPGs!
Yeah, pretty much.
I guess we'll just have to stop after this cutscene.
ここがターが言ってた遺跡なの？エコー。多分そうだよ。オートの、こんな近くに遺跡があったなんて。ここが本当にこんなものがあるなんて。
And it wasn't even that far.
どうかしたの？
いや、僕 遺跡の話を聞いた時にクリム島王国時代のものなんだろうって勝手に思い込んでたんだけどさ
What's the kingdom that got eradicated by the golem tyrannids?
なんかちょっと違うように見えるんだよね詳しくは分かんないんだけどほら空剣島の近くにはクリム島王国時代の遺跡がいっぱいあっただろ
あれはクリント王国時代のよりももっと古いものだよ。ごめん、私には全然わかんない。アンペルさんなら、they're basically tyrannids in how they work except they're made of rock and ore。錬金術に関係あるかもって話だったけど。
それもわかるような、わからないような。あの、すみません。クリント王国って昔この地域にあった大きな国の名前でしたっけ？いや。うん。今はもうとっくに滅んでなくなってるけど、遺跡とか当時の建物は結構残ってるんだ。うんふん。だからチェミ。
その時代よりももっと古い遺跡。そんな場所に入っても大丈夫なんでしょうか？この様子なら、せいぜい途中にいた程度の魔物が住処にしてるくらいじゃないかな。なんだか強くなったね。度胸がついたっていうか、初めて冒険した時のタオなんてビクビクだったのにさ。
あの時と同じにしないでよ。もう、さあ、行くよ。Everything
doesn't look so huge anymore.
いいな、いいな。探求心くすぐられるよ。Nameless
grass.
こうして改めて触ってみると、砂の感触って気持ちいいな。Foamy
water. Soft sand.
いいのは使いなら慣れています。裁縫は貴族のたしなみです。ああ、she's good at sewing. That's good. She even goes outright and says that she's basically a noble. 魔物臭がすごいのが難点だけど、これも必要な材料だもんね。取れた。えい。よいしょ。
These drawings go pretty deep, don't they? Oh, look! Strange red artifact.
A book!
Also that, yes. Some kind of object. Very descriptive there.
けど、古い文字で書かれてる。かつて、僕らと同じようにここを調査しようとした人がいたのかな。
それで、何が書かれてるの？
I mean, he does know how to translate.
文字がだいぶ薄くて。あれ？仏行来たるその日まで、砦はただ眠り続けるものなり。これって、僕が見つけた伝承と同じだ。
Interesting.
それじゃ、そのノートには伝承が書かれているってことですか？
Probably.
たぶん。薄くて読めないところが多いけど、僕が見つけた伝承の倍か、それ以上の長さだよ。
That is quite a bit of text.
どうにかして全部読めないの？
ほとんど消えかけてるからな。どうにか読めるのは。
I see something admirable.
渓谷の底の乙女は起こしてはならぬ。読めないところがちょっと続いて。魔を食う獣は宵の道より現れた。光り輝く神秘の精。この後もちょっと読めない。
The evening bird, huh?
あとは単語程度だけど。悠久の財宝？目指す旅人は。って単語は2つ出てくるみたい。
さっぱりですね。
Interesting.
そのメモの持ち主ってどんな人だったんだろう。
Or should I go distracted? I should have stopped the episode.
きっと僕たちと同じように。
Just as bad as Ryza.
真実と考えてたんじゃないかな。
Look, I get really into this game. It's so fun.
薄くなって読めなくなった箇所も、どうにかして見つける方法を探さなくちゃ。
そっちの道具は？
Just take it. Just take it.
それ、なんとなく、古式ヒグっぽく感じるんだよね。
なあ。
古式
ヒグ。Really, I think it's, you know, from the city.
あ、そっか。パティは知らなかったっけ？そうだな。昔の不思議な錬金術の道具かな。
Yeah, that basically sums it up.
私もどうやってできてるのかさっぱりわからない。すっごく貴重な道具なんだよ。そんなに。確かにあまり見たことがない感じですが。
本当に古式ヒグなんだとしたら、これをここに置いたのは錬金術師っていうことになるのかな。
いや、プロバリ
ー。本当ならね。でも
だとすると、この遺跡は錬金術に関係があるということになるね。
ああ、そっか。うん、がぜん興味が湧いてきたよ。そうと分かれば奥に行ってみよう。
She's also getting fired up. Anyway, I hope you'll have fun. And guess we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.